Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let's take a look at the Finder's List view. Now I usually live in Column View. It's what I use every day, all day. But List view can be useful as well, and some people prefer it. Switch to List view, you can simply click on the List view icon up here, and then you get the contents of a single folder as a list. Now there's a lot of functionality in List view. For instance, you can sort by all sorts of different criteria by simply clicking on the title of each column. For instance, I'm right now sorted by name and alphabetically starting with A to Z. And you can see this triangle here telling me which order things are in. If I wanted to change the order, I simply click on name again and you can see the triangle changes and now everything is sorted backwards. I can click again to switch it back. If I wanted to sort by date modified, I simply click the date modified field and I can go in either direction there. Any column works like that and it's easy to get back. In addition to that, you can also group things. You can go to view and you can say arrange by, and instead of selecting none, you can select one of these things here. For instance, let's arrange by size. When I do that, you can see it breaks it up into groups. You've got these very large files here, smaller and smaller, and then you have folders here at the bottom. Now, you could see that things are still sorted alphabetically inside the groups, but they will stay inside the group. So for instance, if I change date modified, things are sorted by date modified, but inside each of the groups. A lot of times people get stuck with this. They'll set an arrange by like this and get frustrated and they can't seem to be able to get back to a full sort by modified or size or something like that. And the secret there, of course, is to just turn off arrange by. Go to none, and then once again your stuff can be sorted as one complete list. Now these column headings here at the top can be altered. If you go to view and show view options, or command J is always a shortcut for that, you get this great little set of controls here and you could set what appears here. So if you want to have the date created appear as a column, you can. The date last opened, very useful. All sorts of different things that you can add here or remove. So if kind is not something that you care about here, you can turn that on or off. You can also change how big these columns are by simply grabbing the line in between them like that so you can sort things. So I don't have any very large file names here, so I can give more room for other things here on the right. You also can do things here with this size column. You can turn on calculate all sizes for this folder. What that'll do is it'll calculate even the sizes of things like folders. So you can see the folder here has nothing as its size. If I were to sort this, find out what the largest files are here, I would see that the folder's just at the bottom. There's no size for it. But if I turn on calculate all sizes, it will quickly calculate the size of all the files in this folder here, and I could see the size of the folder. Other options include use relative dates. So if you look here, you can see the folder was created today. If I turn that off, it will actually put a date on that rather than actually using a word like today or yesterday. Also, icon preview. You can see that I get these little previews of image icons and things. I can turn that off and I get these just regular icons. If you have a folder that has a ton of files in it, say a folder with thousands of images, sometimes it could be a little slow to look at it in List view because each of these images has to be turned into an icon. So if you use Show Icon Preview, you turn that off, then you'll get a little faster scrolling, especially on maybe an older Mac. Now with it turned on, you can also make an icon size a little bit larger, which might help you find things. You can also adjust the text size as well. You don't have too great of a range. You can go a little bit smaller or larger here, but this certainly would be enough to help somebody who might have trouble reading the normal size, especially maybe on a smaller laptop. Now you may have noticed I've got all the different sidebars and toolbars and everything turned on here in Finder. And one that's particularly useful in List view is the path bar here at the bottom. You may not have that turned on, and if you want to turn it on, you go to view and you can hide or show the path bar there. And it's useful because you don't really see the full path to anything here. So you can kind of get this reminder of where things are that you're looking at by using the path bar. Now in this view you're of course looking at the contents of one folder, but you can look down further into subfolders without actually leaving this view at all or opening a new Finder window. And you can do that with a reveal triangle next to any folder there. And you can see I can see the contents of this and access the files there. I can even go deeper down as many levels as I want. And you could do things like say drag and drop between these, so I can move that into this subfolder here, and I can also move this back out. So you do have some of the ability of column view by using these reveal triangles, and the nice thing is that you can then hide all this stuff when you don't want to see it anymore.